today's video is going to be basically a tour of the room I'm sitting in right now. I'm Elena, welcome to the channel. This room goes by many names. The makeup room, the office, the filming room, the girly room. We call it a lot of things because this room's just kind of a random room in my house. It holds all of my makeup and it has some extra storage back here and a nice big bookshelf where I often keep overflow from my library room. And if you've seen my library decorating video, you know that that room is like really dark and moody. It's dark academia. This room, very different vibe. Very light and airy and girly. You're probably thinking, this doesn't look put together. And that's because it's not. Erin's coming over today, my sister who runs the channel with me, and she is gonna help me redecorate all this background. It's gonna be my physical TBR bookshelf. So we're gonna put all the books on it that I own but haven't read yet. And I think that's gonna be so fun and it will help me when I need to pick a new book, you know? And I will also be giving you a tour of my vanity. This is where I do my makeup every single day. I absolutely love it. I also change it constantly, like basically every other month, I rearrange all of my makeup products. I thought that I would share my current setup with you guys in case anyone is looking for inspiration for how to organize their own makeup or just enjoys seeing other people's makeup collections. I've been collecting makeup for years. Makeup is my number one hobby. Makeup and reading are probably tied. I don't know. I love makeup. So this collection has been built up over the years and it's definitely larger than the average person's makeup collection, but it's not beauty guru status by any means, okay? You definitely don't need this much makeup. Anyway, I'm going to show you my vanity and give you a little tour, and then Erin and I are going to do some magic on my bookshelf back here. So without further ado, let's get into it. So here are all my blushes. Blushes are my favorite makeup products, so I like them to be really on display over here. I'm using books and an old ABH box to prop up these acrylic containers that hold all of my blushes. I'm showing you my Persona blush sticks that I really love. I've got my favorite blush here, the Rose Ink Cream Blush in the shade Foxglove. It's so gorgeous. Looks good with pretty much any eye look. And these hourglass blushes, I have owned these for probably like 8 or 9 years and they still totally work. Color payoff is still good. It's amazing. Powder blushes, I'm telling you, they don't expire to me. This container over here has the blushes that, I don't know, I'm not crazy about. I have them sort of front and center to see if I'll use them more. And this About Face blush, I thought it would come off purple, but it just looks pink on me. So I don't know, I might declutter. But these blushes I love. These Clinique Cheek Pops are so good. The peach and pink one that I have here, they don't even have these shades sold anymore. They're so old, but they still work. I love them. And I have my Dior Backstage blushes. Of course, I have the iconic pink shade that everyone loves. And I have the berry shade. And I recently found these Pat McGrath blushes at TJ Maxx for a deal. And I really love them. Moving up to the larger part of the desk, these are some palettes that I reach for every day, and I just have them in this nice acrylic organizer from largest to smallest so I can see what I'm reaching for. And this organizer I found randomly at a Dollar General one time, and it's really nice. It's good thick acrylic with gold accents. I love it. I wish I could find more of these. This is an old school MAC pigment. Does anyone remember when MAC pigments were like everything? These are some Stila Shimmer, Glisten, and whatever, and Glows. There's so many different kinds, but I really like those formulas. And the Urban Decay Heavy Metal Liners. I use those a lot as well, all over the lid or as a liner. And this is a cup where I keep my mascaras and my lash curler. Okay, this organizer also came from Dollar General. And again, I really wish I could find it. I keep my foundations up here. I tend to not have too many foundations open at a time. Really, one or two is all I need.
the LA Girl Pro Conceal Color Corrector that I use every day, the Fenty Beauty Matchstick, one of my favorite makeup products ever, some concealers. It's a bunch of base products that don't lay down nicely. And in these slots, they're supposed to hold lipsticks, but I have a bunch of Danessa Myricks color fixes over here. I just had to show you the shade Alien. It's such a pretty duochrome. It looks like a sunset. I really love this all over the lid. And I also have 8 shades of the NYX Ultimate Glow Shots. I really like that formula. This container holds all of my face brushes. Does anyone remember when Sephora would give you a free little makeup brush when you hit rouge? If you have this same brush, let me know. I actually use it like every single day for contour now. And I also put some of my setting sprays and a prep product over here because they just fit nicely in this container, which I will link below. And those are my eyeshadow brushes next to it. Okay, this container is technically for nail polish, but I use it to hold some single shadow type products. All of these round products, I find them really hard to store, and so far, this is my favorite method. I really love the Urban Decay Moon Dust eyeshadows. I think they went viral for good reason, but that light shade on the right, Cosmic, it's kind of lackluster to me. It's not as good as the other two, in my opinion. I cannot make my mind up about these ColourPop Jelly Much shades. They are really weird texture, as you can see. They're like wet and goopy, but they look really pretty on the eyes. I don't know, I'm torn. These e.l.f. liquid eyeshadows are also heavily used. I use them as eyeliner all over the lid. Honestly, they're really similar to those Stila formulas I was talking about earlier. And you can probably tell I love the About Face Matte Fluid Eye Paint formula. I use these like crazy, especially that purple one and this green one. That green makes such a gorgeous winged liner. And I have one shade of the Half Magic Glitter Eye Drips or whatever, only because this shade is called Fairies Are Real. I was like, fairies are real, I must have that. Here is my lipstick tower. It makes great use of vertical space on my desk. I've got some old lipsticks that I just keep kind of for nostalgia. Those Merit Signature Lips are my all-time favorite lipstick formula. These MAC Signature Lips, those are a classic to me. This one is the shade Whirl, and I can always tell which one it is because I have a little bit smeared on the bottom. I also keep the NYX Fat Oil Lip Drips or whatever in there. Okay, this drives me nuts. This Peri Para product and these 2 Half Magic lip glosses do not fit in any container. It seriously is driving me crazy. I don't know what to do. Like, do I buy a new container? Do I put them by themselves in a drawer? Do I get rid of them entirely? I don't know. It drives me crazy. Anyway, this lipstick container sitting on the front has some smaller or like shorter lip products, I guess. These e.l.f. glossy lip stains, I wear them to work basically every single day. I have this little tiny Tom Ford lipstick. I know a lot of people don't like minis, but I think they're so cute. I love minis. I really like this Lawless lip gloss, and the packaging on this Besame lipstick is to die for. And behind that, there is a lip gloss organizer. So this holds all of the tall, skinny lip products in my collection. And then pencil-type products go here at the back. So lip pencils are on the far right. And then right next to that, I have some eyeshadow sticks. And then we have more colorful eyeliners, both liquid and pencil formulas, and then the more neutral colors. I recently picked up this Half Magic Magic Flick eyeliner. It's such a weird shape. I'm like scared to even try it, but it's also very intriguing. If you have tried that, let me know what you think. My go-to liquid liners are the KVD Tattoo Liner and the NYX one, although I realized that was actually a brow product that had snuck its way in there. My bad. And here we have some more palettes that I reach for regularly. Although, actually, this ColourPop one, I haven't even tried it yet. I got it as a free gift from Ulta, so I definitely need to actually use that. I also have this Juvia's Place palette. Look at these freaking colors, man. I've only used the purple so far, but I am just mesmerized by that. I'm sure you all know I'm obsessed with the Huda Beauty Pretty Grunge palette. A couple more ColourPop palettes. And I use these palettes a lot. Like, this organizer over here, these are probably my most used palettes. The Sigma and Angela Bright palette is excellent, and the Patrick Ta is a great everyday palette. It's just all of the matte, neutral shades that you could ever need. On the desk itself, I keep this silicone mat because it's really easy to wipe down and sanitize, and just a small mirror, of course. And then under the desk, I did add a little towel bar because I just often find myself needing a hand towel when I'm doing my makeup. And I also added this drawer. It was like a sticky thing that you could like stick underneath your desk to add a drawer where there was no drawer before. So in here, I just keep some tools, all of my brow products, so I can use whatever brow product strikes my fancy that day. I have eyeshadow primers in the back right, and some different prep products and samples that I use. This is a sample of the e.l.f. Liquid Poreless Putty Primer, which I've been loving. The Sigma Switch over here, I use this all the time. You can rub your eyeshadow brush on it and it will take off the color, so you can use a new color without it getting all muddy. It's great. Swooping over to here, we have more base products. I have a couple different highlighter type products back here. That Charlotte Tilbury face palette has a bronzer and a highlighter, but I just store it over here with the highlighters. I still have my Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector in Champagne Pop. That's a piece of makeup history for you there. An hourglass highlighter, just a bunch of highlighting products. And then we have some bronzers and face powders. Here is my little fan from the Dollar Tree that I use after I soak my face in setting spray or Fix Plus. And here are some more face powders. That ColourPop powder foundation doesn't really do it for me. Probably need to declutter that. The Rimmel Stay Matte Powder, I use this every day to set my eyeshadow primer, so I really go through it. That's why you see a bunch of backups there. And I have the Kosas Cloud Set Powder. I really like it, but the shade is a little too dark for my pale winter skin. As well as these powders back here. They're too dark for me as well, but they come in handy in the summertime. All right, these drawers over here. At the top, I have, first and foremost, some floss picks because I'm obsessed with flossing. And I also have some tape. Those are my narcolepsy meds right there. You never know when you're going to need your narcolepsy meds. I've got some clean spoolies and other tools up here. It's a tools drawer. Down here are some palettes that are old or too small to go on the acrylic organizers. That Bake Up Beauty palette, that's not even old, that's new, and I love it. But a lot of these are kind of old school palettes. I wanted to pull out these old Marc Jacobs palettes to show you. I loved these when they came out. I've heard a rumor that Marc Jacobs is going to be releasing cosmetics again, and I would love that because those palettes were great. All right, bottom drawer here. We have some micellar water for when I need to take my makeup off, some Clorox wipes to sanitize the desktop, the Cinema Secrets makeup brush cleaner, and I also keep packaging sometimes randomly. I don't know. I just can't throw it out when it's that pretty. This is a super old palette. This is a BH Cosmetics palette that I have owned for well over 10 years. I just keep it for nostalgia. If you have that palette, oh my god, you are one of the OGs. And I keep some backup sponges, backup Q-tips, and some pumps that I can use for foundation bottles that come with droppers because I've realized I hate droppers. Okay, that's my vanity tour. I will link everything that I can think of below, but now it's time to knock out this bookshelf behind me. Erin's here to help.
Hello. We'll start by taking everything off of the bookshelf and then kind of make a plan on how we're going to put it all back on. She has a long physical TBR list. It's good though, because now you're going to have a very clear section for all the books in your library that you haven't read. So you'll know exactly where to find them. I think it's good.
It's more like options.
Yeah.
You know?
Okay.
Okay. Let's do this.
All right.
So we started by just taking everything off the bookshelf. She has a ton of knickknacks here. She's got plants, candlesticks, a salt lamp, tons of little vases and things. So it was really good to just kind of see what we were working with and wipe everything down. Then we went ahead and put her books, her TBR books, actually just on the bookshelf to see how much room they actually take up. And then we were able to kind of start chatting through which ones she wanted to showcase, which ones she wanted next to each other, and all that. This was a long process. We had a lot of shifting around, and it took a while to kind of get a feel for it.
What about height?
I don't know. I think I need to be the one to hold it up, and you need to be the one to look at it. No, I feel that this is right, too.
Yeah.
Is it relatively straight?
No, I don't think so.
Or level? I mean, yeah, it won't be better. Completely, because the squares aren't completely.
Oh, okay. Hot tip. If you don't have a pencil,
use your Makeup Forever Artist Color Pencil. But hey.
Now that it's all decorated, I am so excited to read these. A few that stick out that I know I definitely want to get through this year are The Poppy War. I'm definitely going to be reading The Bear and the Nightingale and Bookshops and Bone Dust. The Unmaking of June Farrow, that might be first on my list to read this year. These ones at the bottom I've actually already read, except for A Court of Silver Flames, because famously I have not finished ACOTAR. That will definitely be happening very, very soon.
I think it looks good.
I'm honestly so used to seeing it in the background just looking a mess that this looks next level in comparison.
That's a lot of books, though. Are you going to start with The Unmaking of June Farrow since it's front and center?
I guess.
Yeah.
I will read them as it strikes my mood. So, Erin, was it hard?
It was actually harder than I thought it would be, yeah. It's hard when it's not your own stuff. You're
true.
Just like trying to get a feel for what's going on. But I do think it turned out really cute. And I actually saw some books that I want to read that I didn't know you had. I didn't know you had Daisy Jones and the Six.
I just pulled that out of a little free library. How cool is that?
That is cool.
I'm so glad because I had, I guess, like decision fatigue about this or something. I just couldn't even start.
I feel like it's hard because you love Christmas too so much. So taking down your Christmas and like looking into the spring.
It is, that's so true. That really is what it is. Yeah. All of the Christmas decorations are all my favorite things.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's very girly. It's very you.
Yes.
Okay. I hope you liked this video. Thanks for coming along on this Decorate With Us journey. If you liked this video, please like this video. Let us know what you think. If there's anything you think needs to desperately be moved around, we're highly open to suggestions.
Tell us.
Or if you saw any books that you think that Elena should start with, let her know.
Subscribe. Also subscribe.
Oh, yeah. Do that too, please. But until our next video, we'll see you later. Bye.